Hello dear friends, welcome to the Blue Cube channel. In this new course, I plan to teach you Illustrator software from the beginner to the advanced level. Illustrator is one of the most popular graphic design software in the world and is used to create various vector designs, including logos, posters, cartoons, typography, and more. In this course, I will teach you all the basic and advanced concepts and tools of Illustrator in a simple and easy to understand language. By the end of this course, you will be able to easily design various vector designs and improve your skills in graphic design. You should know that Illustrator software uses vector system for graphic work. You may wonder what a vector is. A vector file, also known as a vector graphics file, is a type of file format that uses geometric shapes such as lines, shapes, and points to create an image. This file format has higher quality and resolution than other formats such as JPEG and PNG. Vector files are scalable without losing quality. This means that they can be enlarged or reduced to any size without losing clarity or detail. When you open Illustrator software for the first time, you will see this image. In the middle of the image, there are ready-made presets that we can use. For example, I can use the A4 preset to create designs or write text. On the left side of the image, there is the Open option. If you click on the Open option, you can open projects that you saved on your computer earlier and continue working on the project. For now, I'll press the Cancel button. Now if you click on the New File option, the new document window opens. We can use these settings to create and select presets. Presets are ready-made templates that allow us to create or import designs and images inside them. If you pay attention, there are also ready-made presets in the beginning of the work that have different sizes and are also in this section. The recent section shows you all the presets you have created earlier. The saved section shows you the templates you have downloaded or purchased. The mobile section has ready-made presets for designing in different mobile screen sizes. You can also purchase and download ready-made mobile templates. The web section has presets and templates specifically for the web that we can use for web design and downloading ready-made templates from them. In the print section, there are also ready-made templates for designing and printing. In the film and video section, there are presets with different video sizes for design.
We also use the art illustration section to select presets and create artistic designs with different sizes.
By clicking on the View All Presets option, you will have access to more presets for each of the above sections.
There is another way to create a new preset and open the new document window.
To do this, click on the New option from the File menu or press the Ctrl plus N keys on the keyboard.
The new document window opens again.
We can also create our own custom presets by changing the preset settings in the right side of this window.
Here I define the name of the new preset, which I type my name.
A little lower, we can define the dimensions of the new preset as desired, and I will also define the unit of measurement of the preset. We can choose millimeters, centimeters, pixels, or other units of measurement. Each unit of measurement you choose, the preset and the designs you create later will be created based on the same unit of measurement.
I choose millimeters and set the preset size with width and height of 400 millimeters. Here I define whether the preset is created horizontally or vertically. I choose the vertical mode. In this section, we can define the number of artboards. Artboard in Illustrator is a page used to design and create initial ideas.
We can define any number of artboards, which we will fully address in the coming lessons. The name of the next part is bleed, which we use to create a distance to the edge of the artboard. For example, I can define a distance of 4 millimeters from the edge of the artboard so that the design or text I create does not get too close to the edge of the artboard.
We can determine the distance for each of the four directions, up, down, left, and right.
If I click on the chain icon, I can change the distance of each direction independently.
I set the distance of each direction to 0. Color mode in Illustrator is the method that Illustrator uses to store and display colors.
Each color mode has its own advantages and disadvantages, and it is important to choose the right ones for your project.
Illustrator supports several color modes, including RGB. This color mode uses the three primary colors red, green, and blue. RGB is suitable for digital images, such as images you see on the web or on your computer screen. CMYK. This color mode uses the four primary colors cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. CMYK is suitable for printing, as it can produce a wider range of colors than RGB. If your project is for printing, you should use color mode CMYK. If your project is for digital display, you can use color mode RGB. In the raster effects section, we set the PPI value. PPI stands for pixels per inch. This value indicates the number of pixels in 1 inch of an image. The higher the PPI value, the higher the resolution of the image will be. In Illustrator, you can set the PPI for your document. A higher PPI value will cause your image to have a higher resolution when printed or output to other file formats. In general, for printing, it is best to use a PPI of 300 or higher. For digital display, a PPI of 72 or higher is sufficient. After setting the parameters, click on the Create option to create an artboard. After setting the preset and creating the artboard, I will now introduce you to the software environment. If you look to the left of the image, you will see the tools. If you have used Photoshop software before, you will realize that many of these tools are similar to Photoshop tools. If you hold the left click on any of these tools, or right click once, you will see more tools that you will learn about in the following tutorials. On the right side is the Properties panel. The settings in this panel may change with the selection of different tools and provide us with different options. Currently, since we have only created an empty artboard, it displays the settings related to the artboard. With the use of the unit option, we can change the unit of measurement again. We can also increase or decrease the number of artboards. Now, if I select different tools, you will see that the Properties panel settings also change. By clicking on this option, I can enable or disable the ruler. We can also enable or disable the grid. I do the same for the transparency option. This section is also related to guides. If you activate the ruler and keep the left click of the mouse on the ruler and drag it down, a guide will be created, which we use to adjust the shapes and various things. Note that when I select a guide, the properties panel settings also change. For example, here it shows us the coordinates of the guide location. Also, if you look at the left side of the image and keep the left mouse click on the ruler and drag to the right, another guide will be created. We can also use the align panel to set the location of any guide you select. For example, I place this guide in the center of the image. The next panel is the Layers panel. For every shape we create or every image we import, a layer is created in the Layers panel. We will cover it in detail in future lessons. If I click on this option, which consists of three lines, it will display different settings related to layers. For example, we use these options to create a new layer, copy the layer, lock the layer, and more. The next panel is the Library, which I will tell you how to use in future lessons. Every new preset that we create, the name and specifications of that preset are written in the upper part. If we just hold the mouse on any tool, the software will show us the use of that tool. In the older versions of the Illustrator software, there was a toolbar at the top of the image, but in the new version, we don't see that toolbar. To activate the toolbar above, which is very useful, select the Control option from the window menu. In this way, this toolbar is also displayed. Now, whatever tool I choose, we can use the options in the toolbar above. By choosing different tools, the settings of the toolbar above may change. If you look at the top again, you can see the number 64%, which shows the amount of zoom on the artboard. We can also change this value from here. For example, I choose 200%. In this way, the zoom value of the image increases. If we click on the Fit on Screen option, we can see the artboard in full again. Also, if you press the Control plus 0 buttons on the keyboard, the artboard will be fully displayed again. From this section, we can also rotate the artboard. In this section, the number of artboards is displayed. We have created only one artboard. In this section, I can set, for example, to display the name and number of artboards instead of the selection option. Or I can select the date and time option, which displays the date and time the artboard was created. To move in the software environment, you can move by holding the left click and dragging on these sliders. It is also possible to move in the software environment by holding the space button and clicking and dragging the mouse. Well, friends, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please like the video and subscribe to watch more tutorials. See you next time.